You already know it. It's not nearly as important what notes you're playing compared to how you play them. That's what I'm going to use in this video, because you can take some really basic notes and then work on playing them in a way that sounds a lot better. Once I started thinking more like this, then I really started to feel a difference in what I played, and it really lifted the solos and made them sound much more like real jazz, if that's a thing. Since it's for jazz blues, let's just start with this really basic C7. And then use a simple one octave version of the arpeggio for that chord. Now you can start working on playing these notes and getting them to sound more like a jazz blues phrase. And this is really just about imagining the groove and just see if you can make some simple melodies, something like this. So simple, short phrases in the groove, think Wes Montgomery or Grant Green, and just try experimenting with coming up with some melodies. You can actually get them to sound even better by adding this. And all that you're adding here is that you slide into some of the notes, which is sort of a jazz version of bending strings. Before you move on to another technique, you probably also want to start working on making longer phrases, something like this. Here you want to notice that the longer phrases are really just two phrases put together. So we have one phrase that works as a call, and the other one as a response. You can practice this by just playing a phrase and stop, and try to imagine what you think should come after it. Is it an ascending or descending phrase? A lot of notes? A few notes? Try to start getting used to hearing phrases and listen to what you hear inside. Mostly when you're practicing legato technique, then you're probably working on getting the notes to sound equally loud so that there's no real difference between the picked notes and the ones that you play with hammer-on pull-off. But they do have a different quality of tone, and that's actually something you can use to make your solos much more expressive, add some dynamics to your lines, which is actually really an important part of jazz lines. First, let's just add the rest of the position around the one octave arpeggio. So you have, and that becomes, and we need this because we want to have more places with two notes on one string so that you can actually use legato. That doesn't work really well if we have one note per string. Now you can start creating lines like this. And here the fact that some notes are louder than others really help make the whole thing sound more interesting. It is also something that you can incorporate into your music as a dynamic quality. And in fact, that's what you'll hear with a lot of players like Grant Green, Wes Montgomery, or more modern guys like Pat Metheny. Since you're starting with basic chord tones, then everything you play will sound good, but it's also very safe and maybe even a little bit boring. So besides working with these phrasing techniques, you can also start to add some colors by surrounding the arpeggio with the rest of the scale. So let's do that and then move on to some double stops. So you're going from this, and then placing that within the scale. The best strategy is probably to start by just adding notes in between the notes of the arpeggio. But notice that you can still use the slide to get a different sound. And then the F before the E. So. And you're using scale notes to lead into the arpeggio. Here's another example of how that works. Notice how the slide takes an incredibly simple melody and then really adds a lot of bluesy character to it. The difference between this and this. Double stops are often associated with blues and they work really great for that sound, but there is another polyphonic technique that's also really great to have in your vocabulary, and I'm going to cover that right after this one. You can use double stops as a sort of emphasis on a chord tone, something like this. Here the double stop really becomes sort of the important part of the phrase, and then the descending melody ending on the flat 7 that follows it really drives home the blues feel. This is, by the way, something you will hear Parker do very often, ending phrases on the 7th in a jazz blues, especially just before moving to the 4 chord. Another great way to use double stops could be something like this. The double stop that I'm using here is a tritone, and that's a great choice for really nailing the sound of the chord. Another way to use several voices that Kenny Burrell uses quite a lot would be something like this. Using pedal notes is a great sound, and it's a little bit overlooked, but still something you'll hear in, for instance, Stevie Ray Vaughan's playing quite a lot. One of the things that really boosted my playing was starting to learn solos by ear. You can hear that I reference a lot of different players when I'm explaining what is going on in this video. And learning like this is actually more efficient and easier. At the same time, it can get very difficult because solos are often long and complicated. So you want to choose the right one and not crash and burn while you're trying to learn it. Now, this video will recommend 5 easy and great solos that will teach you a ton of things about jazz. And you don't really want to rob yourself of the feeling you get when you're nailing a solo by ear.